Welcome to Dan ARG YouTube. Talk and Mercy Be with Apostle Alfred Uyinusa. Apostle Alfred, they talk about the Edo State election. Where it won't happen. 19th September. He also talk about the people where go wait for the Edo State governor in front of Oba Palace yesterday. So make I leave you now. Make you hear what you want to talk concerning those people. Enjoy the video.
My people, Mukra, not very, the network just they misbehave. All these evil people, they already try to disturb our broadcast this evening. Them go really, really, really tire. Just disturb the network. Them go tire. Their cup go full. You know, get as the one. God work must prevail. And there's nothing they go fit do at all. They just they try themselves and they will continue to they try themselves. They just they attack the network this evening. They don't want me to do broadcast, but they go fail. In fact, they don't fail. They will continue to fail. So, una good evening, good morning, good afternoon, depending on the area where you watch this broadcast from. Happy Sunday. How are your side? How are your family? How are your children? We thank Baba God for this day when indoor create. Whether the devil like it or not, this broadcast, we go down. Whether they like them or not, this broadcast, they go down. They go attack, they go tire. On a good evening, let us pray. Father, we say thank you for tonight's broadcast. We ask, oh God, that you take charge. We cover this broadcast with the blood of Jesus. We bind the works of darkness. We decree that their operation will not stand over our network. Lord, we take authority over the airwave in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your holy name. Lord, I lift up my brothers and sisters in diaspora and in Nigeria before your throne of mercy. Do for them what they cannot do for themselves. And above all, oh God, speak to us tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Una word on, sir. So, this night, I won't put much for a lot of matter, but with a climax much more. Make we look at the book of Genesis chapter 1 talk. Genesis chapter 1. You will see my timeline there. I write down there. Have dominion. Because a lot of Christians know the meaning of dominion. They just say that just to do one or two things for business. No, it did beyond that one. So we'll read the book of Genesis chapter 1 from 22. I will explain the role of the church for the society and how we don't miss them over time. And how God will still help us to correct them. On a good evening, make away my cap. Alright, Genesis chapter 1, verse 24. Let me start from 24. Sweet Bible talk. Bakasata. Libako soto libakasata. Alright. The Bible says, verse 24, and God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature according to his kind, cattle and creeping things, and beasts of the earth, each according to its kind. And it was so. Verse 25. And God made the beast out of the earth according to its kind, cattle according to its kind, and everything that creepeth on the earth according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Verse 26. And God said, let us make man. And God said, who said? God. Who said? God. And God said, let us make man in our image. There was a consultation in heaven about the creation of man. Look at what happened. According to our likeness, let them have dominion. The Bible did not say let us, say let them have dominion. At that particular time, God separated himself from the creation process. After the creation, he let them have dominion. Let man that have created have dominion. It did not end there. Over the fishes of the sea, over the bird of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping things that creep on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created male. He created him, male and female. He created them. Verse 28. And then God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful. Be fruitful. Multiply. Fill the earth. Subdue it. Have dominion over the fishes of the sea. All and all. Now, let me begin to explain the process. The first thing God created man, as he created man finished, he said, now the first thing God said, be fruitful. So, which means God created man to be fruitful. Man is not dormant. Man is not dormant. Man is to be fruitful. Fruitful in business. Fruitfulness is not only about the fruit of the womb, like as we claim. No. Fruitfulness goes beyond the fruit of the womb. Say, I'll be fruitful. Now be fruitful in whatever you lay your hands upon to do. It should be fruitful. And multiply. So when they ask you, are fruitful in that business, then multiply the business. Everything you find your hands upon to do, multiply it. The first thing is to be fruitful, to bear fruit, ability to create. Then the next thing, you say, what happened? Say, multiply. You need to multiply. After the multiplication, the next thing is to feed the earth. So a lot of us just think it's all about having children all over the world. No, that is not what the scripture is talking about. The scripture is not saying, oh, you must have children that are going to feed the earth. No, though it's part of it, but that is not a total declaration. But that is not the total declaration. And subdue it. Number one, if you are not fruitful and you are not multiplying and filling the earth, there is no way you can subdue it. The Bible does say, and have dominion over the fishes. The fish is not the fish is not scubia, it's not sepsis, it's not tilapia. No, it's talking about the marine powers that control the rivers. And the bed of the earth is not dome, it's not oval. He's talking about the power, the witches and wizards that fly in the air. And over the living creature, over the living thing that move on the earth, eventually everything, including human being and all the animals, they have dominion. That it will say, anywhere you find yourself, you are supposed to dominate. In business, you are supposed to dominate. In academy, you are supposed to dominate as a Christian, be born again. Anywhere you find yourself, you are supposed to dominate. That is to say, as a child of God, you are not restricted from dominating anywhere. In fact, the field is open for you to dominate. So which means, because you are created, you are God's creation, and there is no restriction to domination. There is no restriction. That is to say, you have the ability to go to dominate. That is to say, before I'm going to talk about politics and all that thing. So which means, the Christians are supposed to be involved in politics to gain dominion. You are supposed to be in politics to gain dominion over the political terrain. As a child of God, created in his image. Because politics is not actually made for the unbeliever. Politics is not created for the unbeliever. God not create politics to give unbeliever. No, he created for a creation. And have dominion. So which means, as a Christian, you suppose partake in politics, then you gain dominion. You cannot rule over what you do not dominate. You can only rule over what you dominate. Now, over time, the church has been relegated to background for a very long time. And the church does not play active role when it comes to decision making in our nations and all over part of the world. The church has been dormant like a chicken, but rather we are supposed to be like the eagle. We are supposed to be dominating. But today, the world is not the one dominating the creation, which is error. And the Bible says, have dominion over the fishes of the sea, everything. Have dominion. That is to say, as God's creation, whether born again or not born again, you are supposed to be in politics, giving your life to Jesus, and change the narrative. So we'll be praying, want to go to heaven, even the heaven we are not even prepared. while we suffer here on earth. And the people we are supposed to be ruling over, they are not the one ruling over us. Now let me take some case study. In the National Assembly, Abuja, where our senators are misbehaving and doing all kind of rubbish. Now, if we have more genuine Christians that are in that chamber, now, do you know what will happen? They will have the capacity to influence any bill that will go against the body of Christ, that will go against the masses. Now, but a few people that are Christian, they are not actually Christian because they are not born again. Because the role of the Christian is to change things. Now to have dominion, now you cannot have dominion when we are just few. Now in Abuja, now look at it, the senators, the people in the National Assembly, 85% are Muslim. Yes, 85% are Muslim. So where is the church? Where is the Christian? So they are like the one passing the bill that is affecting on 247. Because the church, the Christian, refuse to go out there to gain dominion. So getting dominion, we are supposed to be involved. By the time we are involved, then we take over. Then we begin to decide what should happen. And this has been the process for years. And God is watching. Let me tell you, God can never do for you what you can do for yourself. Yes. God can never, underline, God can never do for you what you can do for yourself. So we shouldn't pretend about it. God can never. God can never change what you have the ability to change. You know why? In the book of Genesis, the Bible says, let them have dominion. So we mean God relinquish authority to man. To exercise authority on earth. But what do we do as a church? We gather the people from Sunday to Monday, from Sunday to Sunday, doing what? We are praying. We are doing seminars. Why the Muslims are teaching their children how to take over power? When the Islam are doing everything possible to continue to rule over the Christians, and we just throw our hands, we are doing prayer. We are doing program. We are doing seminars. We are doing music jamboree. We are doing fashion parade in the church. Why they are looking at us? But the church came to be wise and learned. But the people, we will say they are not learned, they are the one ruling. Which is error. Error. So, having dominion, it is the right of the saints to gain dominion. Who said Christian cannot go to politics to have dominion? Now, check most of our industry today, all over the world. They are not owned by Christians. They are owned by unbelievers. The Buddhists. The gay men and the gay women, lesbians, the Illuminati. Most of the functioning hospitals in the world are owned by occult men, not Christian. Go and check. If Dangote were to be a Christian, I believe a lot of things would have changed. But we are the Christian. We are nowhere to be found. We are not the one working for the unbeliever. Meanwhile, the unbeliever are the ones supposed to be working for us. Error in the highest order. So that's to say, the truth is this, according to this scripture, the Christians, we are not gaining dominion. We are just relegated to background. We are not gaining dominion. And God is looking at us. We are supposed to rule over everything that can be on the earth, that what the Bible says. But what do we do? We do nothing. Now let me shock you again. When Goliath came to challenge the children of Israelite, what happened? God never acted. No, God folded his hand in heaven because it was never the jurisdiction of heaven to intervene in that matter. Do you know why? The earth had originally been handed over to man. So it is the duty of the man to dominate, and it is the duty of the man to play their role. The heaven will act. When Goliath was setting the children of Israelite, God folded his hand in heaven, was watching them. So, what is that thing that is challenging your life? What is that challenge? What is that problem? The political giant in Nigeria, the gladiator, the evil politician that is shutting us every day, we keep running. The Goliath keeps threatening us, we keep running. And we want God to fight. It's not possible. The broken Goliath keep patching bill that is against the church. What do? We keep waiting. Do you not? You shout that God. But God said, my children, wake up. Wake up. When Goliath continued to challenge the children of Israel, they were running until a man called David showed up. Who is that David that will show up in your family in Nigeria? Some of us have decided to show up to begin to question their powers and authority. Yes. When David showed up, he looked at Goliath. My beloved, come out from your hiding place and challenge that Goliath, the political Goliath, the men in the Asherah, in various sectors that be destroying our economy. Wake up from your slumber and challenge that Goliath. David challenged the Goliath. I do not know the Goliath that have taken over this country, Nigeria. Is it the politics? Is it the commerce and industry? Is it the finance department? Is it the health department? What is that Goliath that is challenging us every day? The time has come for us to come out from our hiding to challenge. When David confronted Goliath, he said, "Oh, you all circumcised Philistines. How dare you challenge God, defy God people? How?" And David said, "Today, I am going to cut off your head with your own sword, and the bed of the earth will eat up your carcass." Boldness. There is nowhere in the scripture that God gave the righteous the spirit of fear. In boldness all the way. When David challenged Goliath, and there was sound in heaven, and God empowered Goliath, and God empowered David, I beg your pardon, God empowered David with just one stone, with the catapult, the string, the Goliath came down. Today, we have the weapon, which is the word of God. What are we doing with it? Gain the dominion. So, go into politics and gain dominion. Go into commerce and industry and gain dominion. Enough of carrying fire to the altar of children depending for job. Enough. That nonsense should stop now. Enough. What I have said before, I'm going to say it again. The 3 kilometer built by Daddy Iya Deboye, if that key 3 kilometer was to be a company, do you know how many people they will employ? Let me pay this call. Hello?
Yeah, like a program
for you. So, I'll say they'll be the call. Sorry to say, if that 3 kilometer was to be automobile company, do you know how many members have succeeded in employing? Thousands. Without waiting for government. Thousands. Yes. Thousands. And those thousands will in turn take care of their family. But what do? We keep building structures. It is not the structure that make the people. It is the people that make up the structure. So then our has come for us to begin to invest in human capacity, not block and sand, not block and road and cement. Sorry to say, but that is the truth of the matter. That 3 kilometer, if that 3 kilometer was to be a company, or to move a company owned by a redeemed church, I tell you, even if they do not employ that members from anywhere, and they will only employ members of redeemed, beloved, come on, poverty will die natural death. A lot of people will be sacrificed, no, but that's the truth. That is the truth of the matter. To gain dominion is not only about building church structure. Today we are ready, we are not ready. We are not ruling. As I'm concerned, the Nigerian church, we are not ruling. We are not reigning. We are not gaining dominion. We are raising lazy men. Institution. We have more Christians in various offices. But to the most of the Christians, we are able to keep right. If they are able to make students to suffer more in school now. Yes. Because they are not born again. So how do you not gain dominion? You can't gain dominion over what you have no knowledge about. Yes. When a lot of people say, "Apostle," but that's the truth of the matter. Say it the way it is. If that 3 kilometer was to be an automobile company, oh my God, do you know how many people they would have employed? Thousands. But we'll keep shouting, oh, government, no. Let us play our part and gain dominion. God gave authority to man to gain dominion. How come we're not gaining dominion? How come? We're not gaining dominion. We're just there. Binding and losing and praying. Doing program. And God is just looking. Train people to go into politics. Train them to go into commerce and industry. Train them to take over the environment. You can be selling granite, you will gain dominion over that environment where you are selling granite. That you, people begin to supply to people. You employ 1 or 2, 3 persons. Oh yeah, your job is to fight the granite. Your job is to bottle it up. You are gaining dominion in that area. But what do? We depend on God. We depend on government. What an aberration. When God said, go and have dominion. God said, multiply, replenish, and subdue. You cannot subdue what you cannot control. It is what you control, you have subdued. To subdue is to gain control. The church has supposed to be gaining control. But today, the world are not gaining control over the church. The world is not the one subduing Christians. Today, Christians have become a professional beggars in the street. We'll finish job, finish school. We'll be praying and looking for a job. Error. We are not supposed to be looking for a job. We are supposed to be creating job because we have the capacity. But what do? We keep investing on structures. Like the $1 billion I saw that a man used to build church for at Oyedepo, and they went to be happy. We just, oh, if that $1 billion, Oyedepo said, no, build company where you can employ people. Do you know how many persons they will employ with $1 billion? Talk him as a bit. Do you know how many persons they will employ? I don't know. We are just too crazy about building. Too crazy, but not building the people. We are not building the people. We are not building the people. We are supposed to be building the people, but we are building structures. That's the reason why the Nigerian church does not have regard in the eyes of the government. What are we doing? We are not even doing anything. We are just doing church, pray, dance, entertainment, finish. Error. And the Bible says, then God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful. As Christians, we are supposed to be fruitful. But we are not fruitful. We are not fruitful. Multiply, we are not multiplying. We are not there. Now, to multiply simply means that you are one person in that company, all of a sudden, you dominate, you begin to bring more Christians into that company. What I think you are multiplying, not multiplying your pocket. But most Christians that enter everywhere, what they do is to multiply their pocket, not multiplying other persons. Error. And multiply. To multiply is to bring more person in that area, whereby more Christians benefit from that angle. But for today, we don't do that. We don't. We are not multiplying, but only multiplying our pocket. And I'm saying, feed the earth. So the Christians are supposed to feed the earth with wisdom. We'll talk about oil industry, it's controlled by Christians. We're talking about a Greek is controlled by Christians. Tell me how many farms owned by a church or a Christian. No farm. Fulanis. The outsiders. They are the ones dominating. Go and check the oil industry. How many Christians? 79.9 are Muslim. They are the ones gaining dominion over us. So it is time to leave the structure. Go out there to dominate. Go and dominate your world. Step out of that church building. Get out from the church building. Go out there to dominate. Get out of the church building. Enough. Go out there to dominate. Go into politics to dominate. Go into commerce and industry to dominate. Everywhere you find yourself, go and dominate. Not to sit in the church 24/7 doing nothing. People are busy walking behind the church, doing program from Monday to Sunday. What kind of program is that? What kind of program? Now we go to church pass, but yet we are still baffled. So, that gaining dominion. Make an enter another matter. But I don't want to go think about that first topic. But still on dominion. If wood not the wood, and no fee enter. Oh, when or Iran, who are you? The worm that is eating the wood is inside the wood. Yes. I will remember the chicken is not always happy when they are roasting the bird, because the chicken feathers are roasting its kind. What transpired? What did happen yesterday? And also, some people know they will not go analyze them because they are full of lies and deceit. Now, let me open some secret up. Governor is a man of protocol. Now, the second matter I want to put this up. Governor is a man of protocol. And I believe that before he go palace, he send invitation to our king to inform the king, I am coming so day with my people to seek for your royal blessing. Yes. Yes. How come the same day that the governor said it's coming to see the king, that day the king was doing the ceremony, whereby APC members were there? Whereby APC member the dig gate doing what? Doing what? I mean, more than not trust against me, but more than just think over this matter. Before the governor go palace, go see our king, I believe she does schedule day and time. She's so deep, we come see you for real blessing. How come on that same day our king do naming ceremony and APC members in the palace? It's a serious matter. But that's the truth of the matter. How come? Which means they were pre-informed, they were organized. Those guys were really organized. Because I watched the video. They were organized. Those guys are prepared. Now, let me also shock you. They carry a banner bearing Captain Osa banner. Say this is the son of the soil, our son. And the person that sponsored that banner was Osaron Obaze, who happened to be a boy to Captain Osa. Is Captain Osa contesting? Logical. Is Captain Osa contesting any position? So what was the banner doing in the palace when Obaseki was coming with other governor from other states to the palace? Let no talk as it be. And so people say, oh, Pastor, I say the way it is. So which means the first suspect of who that orchestrated that problem yesterday is Captain Osa boy, because that banner was bearing Captain Osa and Obase feature. So is Obase contesting for governorship? Is Captain Osa contesting for governorship candidate? No. So what was the banner doing there at the same time that the governor was coming to see the king? Was the palace a political gathering? Were they doing running palace? No. So what happened? Something is fishing. Now, when the governor they come, they go see the king. What happened? We were hearing Obaseki Ole, Obaseki Ole. What did the man done to deserve that rubbish? What has he done? What did he do? You catch him for chief.
with you. It teaches you. So with me, when I was saying day before yesterday, I talk about the lions and tiger have been released and they cry. So people teach that a joke. I talk him. I'm not talking. I said the tigers and the lions have been released. They want some blood. They want drink you. They want flesh. I'm not talking. I'm a prophet, but when I tell you the joke. When I do that video day before yesterday, I said the lions and tigers have been released. When I told you that the joke, and the tigers and lions, they showed their true color yesterday in the king's palace, abomination. Such thing has never happened in the history of Benin. It has never happened. The political parties will be fighting in front of the palace. It has never, since I grew up in this, it has never happened. Other candidates go to palace to see the king, to see the royal blessing. It is normal. But what happened yesterday was abomination. It has never happened in the history of Benin. So I beg you to sit down and think this matter. It has never happened. Just to embarrass the governor. For what? No, for what? Why you don't go to Base Stadium? Because I'm Base Stadium, they want to do the rally. Why they don't go to Base Stadium? Must it be in the palace? Must these people go to the palace gate to do what? Now, if the king was doing the naming ceremony, what concern the APC you do the naming ceremony? What are you guys doing? If not, you can was if not be troubled and they will not go look for. Yes, let me realistic here. Where do you go do naming ceremony? Now I do the naming ceremony. Why vision that the day when God and one goes see our king, now the culture and one go greet up for naming ceremony? Something is fishing somewhere. Thereby giving the palace bad name. Is bad abomination. The security agencies should wake up to their responsibility and do the needful. And I will thank God for governor for telling the PDP supporter never to retaliate. But I hear some of them talk like, "Oh, Obaseki can never destroy what he's making. It's not possible." You don't see a man with a beard that will destroy the other himself. Not possible. I want the youth to not die. You receive bullet for your waist, you still a worker. Let's stop those makeup. The truth is this, yesterday's attack was planned. They want to disgrace government, but they end up disgracing themselves. And they come finally tell the world that the lions and tigers have arrived. Truth is bitter, but we'll be talking. Truth is bitter, but we'll be talking. We will talk and say, so we'll be yesterday attack the planner. Why they don't go stadium? Why they don't go stadium? Good evening, sir.
Hello, my apostle.
Yeah, good evening, sir.
Sorry, make a low my DC first. Let me not disturb the call.
You are going to introduce yourself.
So,
okay,
you know,
the call. You don't say calling. I'm going to call the director. Hello.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Yeah, you don't like Navi?
Yes.
I hear your talk regarding the talks we happened for front of Oba Palace yesterday.
Yes.
Our governor, make our governor not just sweep this thing on that carpet. Our governor supposed to make it come out, make it address the whole Edo's. Because if he not show instead, they will still say this governor weak. Because what they tolerate yesterday, I'm not sure say, even though say my democracy will be. Nowhere where they tolerate this thing. If they want to protest, in a logical protest, they should inform any local government authority say they want to protest, and it should be notified. According to the way the APC communication advice chairman, they talk say that they protest, which was a very, very wrong language. I not understand the kind of protest where they protest. And now, secondly, most of the video where they circulate for social media, some of them is doctored.
Yes.
Some of this video where they all some injury where they show, even look at the boys, it's like they carry another person, boys put for those some of their boys. I don't know where they get some of the videos from.
Yes.
So we would like, as an adult life, we would like the state governor. I know say than all the Duffy address media today, but we will also want to hear from our state governor to address this issue, because we need to start clear warning to those calls that just organizing this mayhem, because he get executive power to okay, make sure say the country, even the people of the doctors are safe and secure. He need to send a clear warning. If I'm not the same to sit down, look, no. I don't want our Yekme or Masa Aoma Yomwa. Our government need to speak up. He need to make sure that, yes, listen, he is the executive state governor of the Edo State. He have a veto power to quench any toggery, any insecurity in the state. He's so responsible for it. So it's good maybe say may we hear from our governor. I'm not saying he made some remarks yesterday for in campaign rally.
Yes.
But we need him to talk. He need to talk to us. Say what these people carry out yesterday. Is the wrong act? Is evil act? They want to destabilize the state. They want to spoil our name. They want to spoil our urban name. So he need to place them where they are. Whether they flag as the Osa and the Osaka banner. They say they call for baby naming. What you call concern baby naming, concern Osarol and Kasosa banner, where they call the Jubilee here and there. So our governor, we need to make this broadcast which way, they make our governor address us. We want to hear from now.
Yeah.
You know, my contribution will be that one of that.
Thank you. Yeah. So whoever want to call, please just call direct, don't call the WhatsApp, because the direct call was so bullshit. So whoever wants to call in, just call us direct. If you call the WhatsApp on that call, we call, come in, you will not be able to communicate with us. So, I get very logical. That I'm an apostle. So, it's very easy. So, why they will protest on the day we go to the conference? Why they don't go stadium? Now, when it concerns Osaro Obaze and Kabiusa banner for naming ceremony, one, that number two, three, why they call a shout of Obaseki only when he wanted to pass? It's ifuna. Now, it's ifuna. So, what happened yesterday was treason. Yes. So, you mean you wanted to kill a sitting governor? That was the plan. Not just a sitting governor. You know how many governments did it? Wike, Makide, just check all the PDP national chairman, all the leaders with me. If they get bombed yesterday, then we want to eliminate all PDP leaders yesterday. Come on now. What is bad is bad. Now, the issue of governor addressing the people, the first thing that the party, which is PDP. The PDP organized what press conference today. So the first thing now the party. So they not just only attack the governor, they attack PDP. So at that particular time, the PDP leaders do the needful. This morning, they address the world conference. They address the world. So which is the right step? Maybe from tomorrow Monday, the governor will start talking to the people, because the campaign has started. What happened yesterday, to me, is an assassination attempt. And I remember I prayed some prayer here. Anybody plan to kill the governor? Every time they talk for this broadcast, one of them use a joke, one of them write them down. Now, in our reach, they begin to destroy all of Obaseki banner. any motor when they push PDP sticker, they will destroy. For what? Wait. Now, when I never come government, when I don't let the decision, I want to detail for the people. I'm not even like the government. Let me tell you the truth. Yes. Must everybody support you? Who knows support the JM will not be touching up with debt? Must everybody support the JM? No. Everybody has freedom of expression. Everybody get right to leave. You can't force anybody to say you must vote to APC. No. What did they do yesterday? Now the same thing they do for Imo. When they begin to destroy opponent banner. The same thing they do for Imo. Who orchestrated Oshomole? The same thing that happened yesterday. The same pattern. The same pattern. The same pattern. Now they think they're going to destroy for Imo State. The same pattern. When they cry, they see road. Would they cry the sea road? So my people, my greatest joy be saying there was no retaliation from the opponent. Let me turn on their plan. The second point was that let's assume the thing escalates yesterday. Then they wait me further deploy army. The government should be intelligent for that. But don't worry. This election is going to be peaceful by the grace of God. Hello?
Hello, good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening, sir.
What? Yeah, may I know you? Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
That is not McCarthy, your prayer. Your prayer, you always pray. You already see vision to come. They are planning to keep going.
Yeah.
Predicting for that the same month before it happened
yes.
That is how to know the prospects. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Now, what happened yesterday in the economy? We have to our governor, Mr. Fada. Do you know what it means for other governors to deal with governors and four or five governors? So, say that yesterday, governor still did it, should open fire. To block governor, governor conference to block Kista. You know what it means? It got under the soldiers to open fire. If they open fire, they have to make some sense. They will say, ah, Obaseki has done again.
Yes.
They said it before. He betrayed the balance. That's what we were looking for, sir. That's why they get to Rosa. What they call it, the figure of Benin Shimote, Kabaka, the lion and the tiger. That was their plan, sir. It's only the governor did not fall for their plan.
Yeah.
It was everybody that for that palace the full of they say, hey, they talked it before. That governor, they betrayed the palace. That was what they were looking for. And governor with the wisdom and King Solomon. I look him at the King Solomon. I say, God, I don't need money. I don't need wealth. But give me the wisdom to rule my people. That is the governor perfectly for me.
Yes.
That governor perfect is not weak. Because when I call speaking, I can't be thinking about it. I said, no, this man is not good. He's using the wisdom of God to rule like King Solomon.
Yes.
Sir, make we give God your battle hand for Goza. For
Goza.
For
Goza.
Perfect
night. Goza.
Your prayer is smoking. You have seen this one before it happened.
Yeah.
You have seen it before. You are really great apostle for our time. Thank you for the truth, sir.
Thank you,
God
sir.
Bless you.
Amen,
more anointing. Amen, any one plan against you, man or woman that born of woman, she will die before that time.
Amen.
Any woman that plan against you and your family, she will die before that time.
Amen.
Because you are saying the truth, the pastors in Nigeria, the chief in Nigeria, they want to do any war against you. God will visit them by night,
Amen.
Visit them by afternoon, visit them by evening, they will confess with their mouth
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you so very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I love my governor. I love my governor. That is the Solomon of our time.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you. God
bless you. What a brilliant contribution. If to say the keeper say, oh, they say governor, but no, you know they scratch body, they scratch you. No. You don't scratch body where they scratch you. No. Man of wisdom. The governor is not weak. But the truth is this, Now the same thing, now they do when you go say Oshomole for Yamo. When I remember when Oshomole, the same boys, when they disgrace the upper of Lagos. So if they feel disgrace the upper of Lagos, who they don't feel disgrace? Yes. This is the second time. Make an open fire. This one is the second time. Second time. Oshomole, they do something for Yamo. Where the real upper of Lagos and the rest. They go see Oshomole after the convocation. What happened? They attack those traditional rulers. So not be today Oshomole start up. But Governor Riyad, Norega said, Etwa. It is only an empty vessel that makes the loudest noise. And I appreciate Governor for the wisdom. The election I will talk now, we must defend our vote. Now, on that picture where they paint yesterday, then they do dress rehearsal and say, ah, that's what they scare people, make people not come vote. Nala. Nala, no work. I beg, more no fear. They never enter power, they don't scare people, they don't go work. What happened in Kogi will never happen in Benin. I don't worry. Peace must reign. Peace must reign. This election is going to be free and fair. When I was saying, go black thing. Everybody will come out en masse to vote. So now, this is the time now for us to defend our votes. Now. Get your BBC, don't stand anywhere, they go bring and come out. We need to defend our vote. We must vote for the candidate of our choice. You can't put gun on people's head that they must vote for you now. Without past that stage. Make I talk him again, and I talk him yesterday, I go repeat him again, without your favor. If they kill any pastor for Benin, kill anybody for Benin because of this election, redeem churches worldwide will be shut down. I don't put water for my talker. Because Eze Yamu is traced to the church. If that kind of attack is coming from a man who's supposed to be a Christian, so what do you expect from one that plate sucks? And I watch the video where Eze Yamu instructs all the lions and tigers to move from your own world and go to another world. Make sure you deliver. It is what you deliver that you determine what you will get. No. A man of God you are does not do such a thing. No. If truly you are a Christian or born again, you don't do that. So which means Israel actually give them the marching order to make sure say they destroy the election. That was the implication. And that alone is enough to put Israel to jail. That statement alone is enough to put to send Israel to jail. You don't do that. Pastor, go and start retracing yourself. Pastor, retrace yourself. What is bad is bad. What is not good is bad. And you also assure them that because that your fight is going to benefit only the admirals, not the entire Benins, not the entire Edo. Pastor, is that a motive? That you are actually fighting for the Agberos, not for the entire Edos. Pastor, what shall it profit a man if he gains his own word and loses his own soul? While you were here, I lack one team. Get your PVC. But the election is going to be peaceful. Hear this. The enemy of progress in this state they will keep using their hand to sponsor what will destroy them. Yes. And what just happened yesterday, if you set up interstate war, yes, those things can stay up interstate war. That's the truth of the matter. Let's assume the governor or the advisor, the people revolt, say, you wanted to kill our governor? Then that people rise up, you wanted to kill our governor? No. Interstate war, let me what happened yesterday. And those governors, when they come, and the people go rise up from those areas, how long do you think the country will be by now? Remember, no man can fly away from this earth. No man can fly away from this earth. You will certainly reap what you sow. What happened yesterday reached to cause interstate war. What happened yesterday reached to cause interstate war. And the river will rise up. And when people rise up, data people come rise up. But some people rise up. Interstate war. We don't need that. God bless Mr. Godwin Nowelase Obaseki. If you want campaign, campaign with facts. Tell us why you want. With your simple agenda, and then they actually dismissed today. The simple agenda is destruction. That be happening today. Simple agenda. So why destroy PDP, balance, destroy vehicle? What did they do? What happened? So it was a planned attack. Lord, any covenants with the spirit of the dead to suck blood in this land. Father, whoever that is orchestrating it, let them use their head to carry it in the name of Jesus. Lord, any covenant that is working against the state governor, this day Jehovah, by the blood of the Lamb, will destroy such covenants in the name of Jesus. Father, oh God Almighty, the God that seeth the word and cometh to pass, arise and fight this battle. And help us, oh God, to move ahead to challenge the Goliaths in the land. Jesus. 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 Continue to grant the governor wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to know what to do. Lord, help the governor. Help him. Lord, we know that come September 19, the election is going to be according to your plan. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Any evil altar they have risen against the governor, Father, today, let the altar begin to consume whosoever that raised it up. Let that altar begin to consume whoever that raised it up. And above all, oh God, let the lions and the tigers, Lord, today, according to the book of Genesis, chapter 1, Lord, we gain dominion over the creeping things. We gain dominion over the lions and tiger. Lord, we gain dominion over their sponsors. We gain dominion over them all. By the power of the Holy Ghost, we gain dominion over them. We gain total dominion. In Jesus' name. Amen. So, my people, let's continue to pray. Let's continue to trust God to help us to support the governor. Get your PVC prepared. And I trust God, his will certainly come to pass. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. The Bible says, whosoever that digeth a pit shall fall therein. Anyone digging pits for this state, for the governor, they will fall into that pit. And anyone rolling the stone of political war in this state,
Lord, that stone will roll back to them 1 million times. Anyone rolling the stone of political war in this state to cause war, Father, today we roll that stone back to them in the name of Jesus. Oh, they say, ah, government did not work. Oh, government, oh, God did not create, oh, God, government create his job. Some of our youth are too lazy. They just need quick money. Quick money. For how long? A man is building a nation, building a future. You guys are fighting? No. You don't need to fight. Calm down. The people, you want to govern the people and you are killing the people. Who do you want to govern? I don't know why evil has been synonymous with APC government. Evil. Evil. When Buhari talk about the Babu will suck blood. Are the Babu not sucking blood today? Just yesterday, they granted scholarship to repentant Boko Haram. Their families, where they keep, why they not give their family scholarship? Misplaced priority, wicked leaders. Now that one, why you supported the protest for? On a day here, and it's shameful now. But I didn't give scholarship to Boko Haram people on a day here, and they fight. Except for them to go protest against Buhari. Say, ah, you know, we were there here, you don't give a scholarship, you didn't give no criminals and murder scholarship. When I did not protest, shame. When I go think with the talk so. Some of us are not talking out of fear, no. Dead body not the fear coffin. But some of us don't feel die now. 120 years old. One of the threatening pastor, one of the threatening people again. Just make your point. Use your mad talk. Must you insult people? Must everybody follow your God? No. Must you vote? No. Talk. Leave the matter. Leave the matter. Must you threaten people? Any pastor, when he will come, you say, apostle, don't talk about politics again. Go and be preaching Bible. Now God, and how bad way they preach, now will judge you. Any pastor, when he will call me, so say, apostle, don't talk about government again. You'll be preaching the Bible. We can tell you. You'll collect. Any pastor will say, pastor, why you not join your fellow pastor? That tongue that will scatter your church. Because you know if you force me. Can't force me. Everybody have freedom of choice. Everybody have a right to leave. Everybody get an opinion. I said, my Lord, come this evening. No one shout. So that everything that they talk, will sink into our head. Will they sink into our head. So I beg all the Christians, step out of the church, go and join politics. Go and join political parties. Go join political party. Go and get your PVC. Go and register. Join political party. We don't live out for them again. Because if we plenty, we'll change things. If we plenty for the game, we'll change the game. Politics is not a dirty game. Now the mind of the people now is dirty. That's why the book of Romans says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, how you take change things where you know they? You can only change things that you are involved in. So I beg all those teachings, you can make it and go to we don't want those motivational teaching again. Right now, everybody, oh yeah, go and start joining parties quick. Anywhere in your day, you'll be greeted. Join. Join union meeting, join. And change narrative. Go and join. Join any party. Any party of your choice. If you want to join PC, you'll join anywhere, go join. But we'll change the narrative. When they want to join APGA, you want to join, go and join a political party and participate. Enough of this fear laziness method. Oh, they talk with the prayer. We know if they join to change the narrative. As I really talk, so most Christians never get PVC. Now when they do church. Mona, come on to that church. Mona, come out. Go and join parties.
Then on Sunday we'll come back, we'll listen to the gospel. Then on Monday we'll go back and go back to our career. Your office dominates. Wherever they do business, dominate. You be tailor, dominate. You be carpenter, dominate. You be fish seller, dominate. That way, the only Bible talk say gain dominion. Oh yeah, go dominate. What thing? Go dominate. We don't keep quiet with it. Go dominate. Go and have dominion. What the Bible talk? Say, I have dominion. Go to police and have dominion. So if you change things, you mustn't be a pastor, you mustn't be an apostle like me. You mustn't be a pope. You mustn't be a bishop. So let me teach our members the right message. All those motivational teachings, we don't hear it. We don't do it, we don't hear. None of us want to become doer. Let us become doer. So step out of your comfort zone. Church, we are too comfortable in church. Oh yeah, step out of your comfort zone. Step out. Go and make the change. Now let Nigeria and Nigeria will be. Now we go to church, but here we know they develop. Something wrong somewhere now. Oh yeah, come out. Come out. Oh yeah, join. Join political party, PDP, APC, any part of your choice. Go and join. Go and participate. We don't go for that again. We are supposed to be ruling. We are supposed to be king and queen. We are not behaving like slaves. Are we supposed to be slaves in our own land? That every people they pray for, go here and look and say, what do they pray for? Christian of today be like man when he married woman in the way make Holy Spirit give him belly. How you want to walk? You must play your part. You must play your part. God can only back you up when you are doing things. You fold hand. You are saying, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, give us a good leader. Are you not a leader? Go and join the political party and change the narrative. Politics is not a dirty game. Now the heart dirty. And by the time we go in there, we change the narrative. Period. So all those students say that politics is a dirty game in the line. Politics actually need gentlemen. David was a king. He played politics. God chose him. What are you talking about? To rule over the people. That politics. God chose David. What about Gideon? Go and check your Bible. Solomon, go and check them. We don't read the Bible. Solomon, go check him. Solomon was a king. That's a politician. When all the party elders, leaders, not the only one, the Gideon one now, show the party leader, the elder, they surround Solomon. When we are like, Solomon, God give me wisdom. That should be the role of a Christian. God give us wisdom. Begin with Yahweh the Grand. Baba God, how we do? I'm a brother. Have fun. He will tell us what to do. David was a politician. He was a king. Now, if you check with the Bible, talk. Check when the righteous are on authority, the people rejoice. Make I tell you, the righteous cannot be an authority without joining a political party. Because the unbeliever will step down for you. He will step down for you. So you join. Start from your one level. Join. Not be Bible, you want to be more active. We are just dumbass. We are supposed to be eagles. The Bible says the righteous are bold like a lion. But today the righteous are now fear like chicken. The righteous are bold. Bold. Oh, I don't want to die now. I don't want it to kill me. Rubbish. And they will kill me. Who will kill you? Nobody will kill you. Nobody will kill you. Go and join the political party. Go join. Go join the political party. Go join. Go join. Understand? Go join. You will have more Christians in politics and play an active role. But some of them support the corner by now. Even by now, some of them support the talk on national TV. By now. No, some of them support the talk about. But some of them support the house. And some of them dare open the mouth and say, why I'm opposing Obasanjo election, or God, who you be? Oh God, which right you get? Now you want to decide. No Godfather. Oh God, Shumole, no Godfather. Now you talk him. Now you fight against Anemi and the rest. So will he fight against you with your own words? One by one vote. Not be one by one gun. Forget him. When I talk to the church people with papa, you don't do. You know, all of them don't care about family, go abroad, go hide. Think it's soon I will say that lie. Even though they keep people for years, my family for abroad, they will kill them for that side. Not be threat, because what you plan, you will reap. Then you say you can't keep people, now your children will come lead to a jail and a lie. So the words don't advance past that level. So maybe, very important. When I do when I shall go call them a day. Those of my way call, wonderful contribution. Those of my way who try to call through the WhatsApp line, God bless all of you now. Above all, this is time for us to pray more. Pray for the state. That God will intervene in the affairs of the state. Pray that the will of God will break forth. Pray, don't fold your hand. No talk, say, don't concern me. It concerns everybody. It concerns everybody. Yes. Father, we say thank you for tonight's broadcast. We ask that you take charge. Do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. Lord, we decree that you will show yourself strong and mighty in this election. Jesus, you are the only lion in the tribe of Judah. Every other lion are counterfeit. Therefore, begin to deal with every satanic lions that have been released to devour human life in this forthcoming election. Father, begin to arrest them one after the other in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, anyone conspiring against the government for whatever reason, Father, let their conspiracy end in futility in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless all of you now. Tomorrow now, another day, God will help us to continue to put mouth and to continue to say the right thing. God bless you now. Una, good night.
If you get anything to add, join with the apostle.talk for this video. As you don't hear everything when you talk, go to comment section, make you put them for there. And this video, make you help us share them. Thank you for watching Dan ARG YouTube.